According to the Minister of Gender, Labour and Social Development, Betty Amongi, each district will receive at least 3 million shillings starting next financial year to facilitate organisation of Women's Day celebrations.
I will write to the Chief Administrative Officer to indicate that that money, the woman MP must participate in its budget for the Women's Day. We'll also write to tell you the focal point person.
MPs want this money allocated to district woman MPs as focal persons. District woman representatives say they have been drawing money for these events from their own pockets.
I want to appeal to districts. Having functions in an urban area alone does not have an effect because it becomes monotonous. So we want to encourage the people, the women at the district level, to move to the grassroots at the sub-county level, because that you are inspiring the girls at the grassroots level to be like we who are already leaders in this country.
The entire budget proposal for districts is 405 million shillings. Female MPs under UOPA urged government to channel this money directly to women MPs instead of sending it to district administrators who abandoned the mandate of organizing Women's Day celebrations to them.
It has always been the women members of parliament of the various districts that labor and work so hard to see the Women's Day celebrations come to pass in their various districts. So it is very good for the Honorable Minister and the Right Honorable to say that this money should be overlooked. The focal person should be the woman member of parliament of that district, who have always carried the burden of this Women's Day celebration, and the whole budget is always heaped on our shoulders and heads. So it is going to relieve us somehow a little bit, but we want this money to be used for the right purposes.
The third Deputy Prime Minister, Lukia Nakadama, who represented the Vice President at the launch of the strategic plan of Uganda Women Parliamentary Association, urged female MPs to monitor the implementation of wealth creation programs rolled out by the government in different areas so as to ensure that they benefit women more.
And has emphasized that, has put it right, that 30% of women should get that money. Out of the 100 million, we should have 30 women. That is 30 million, yes. Out of that, we have 30% of youth. But among the youth, not all are men. We have girls there.
Nakadama reiterated the government's commitment to fight female genital mutilation by working with governments of Kenya and South Sudan to fight the practice, which takes place across borders.
So that the FGM, as government, we shall take it up and have bilateral engagements to strengthen that fight and eliminate and end the FGM among our children, among those communities who still think that it is a culture, it is a good culture, which is not. So I think we have to work together and see that we work on that.
The five-year strategic plan is aimed at revamping the environment by planting more trees, fighting corruption, monitoring the parish development model, among others. Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.